So I got my dude DG Mindset in here. We're gonna do a little short topic, man, while we hit these sleds, man, get our knees right. But man, there's so much information and knowledge, man, nowadays just about consciousness, about how to evolve out the matrix. You know, it's a lot of matrix talk. So my dude DG, man, we're gonna kind of break down, like, what are we literally living in? Is this a dream? Is this our imagination? Is this a game? Is this an illusion? You know what I'm saying? But I think DG says, man, we living in a simulation. And so I wanna ask him, man, what's that mean? And like, how do we win if we in a simulation? So first and foremost, man, what do you mean we living in a simulation, D?
So if we look at it, let's figure out what a simulation is.
What's a simulation?
Is an environment that seems so real you can't tell that it's not. Just like when you put on VR goggles, right? You get immersed in the game, you really think that you're in the game, right? Hitting stuff and all that. So Nick Bostrom, who's a doctor, Dr. Nick Bostrom at Oxford University, came up with an algorithm that basically said, we're living in a simulation. And I don't have the algorithm right now, I'm not gonna break it down, but.
What's his name again?
Dr. Nick Bostrom. Right? Yeah. From Oxford University. But if you look at every ancient religion has acknowledged that this right here is not our base reality. Mm. If you believe you go on to heaven, that means that this isn't real. Heaven was real because that was what was eternity, right? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we don't realize we're human beings. Human being. Spiritual plane, mental plane, physical plane, right? The physical plane was where the human lived. The mental plane was where the mind lived. The being lived on the spiritual plane. But here's the thing, D. It operates outside of space and time. So this is what people don't realize. If you play video games, if you're playing, let's just play, we play in NBA 2K.
Yeah.
And I'm playing with LeBron. LeBron goes in for a layup. LeBron in that game, let's say LeBron really thinks he went in for a layup. But what LeBron doesn't realize is that there's somebody on their couch with the dog sitting next to him controlling LeBron. See what I'm saying?
But you feel like this is what you believe.
This is right. Yeah, you stay with me. I'm gonna bring it all together.
I'm following.
So what happens is, LeBron doesn't realize he's not the one who's laying the ball up. He thinks it's him. So when we look at our own lives, this is LeBron in the video game. This is why we're called a human being. The being was the non-physical spirit, consciousness, essence, the breath of God, whatever you want to call it. That has to exist outside of space and time. How do we know this? Outside of space and time, what we call the quantum realm or the field, right? Mm. Every scenario already exists. So when you have intuition, you have these intuitive thoughts, this is the part of you that exists outside of the simulation that's giving you information down in the game. Just like when you play LeBron. Mm. When you play LeBron, you already know where the hoop is, you play Super Mario, you know what bosses come, because you exist outside the game. Mm. So a lot of people don't realize this right here was the same, like this isn't it. Mm. There's a part of you that exists outside of that game. Mm. And we can break it down even more because we live in a fractalized universe, but the Big Bang. The Big Bang was when the game turned on. Mm. Mm. That was when it's like literally powering up your Xbox. That was when the game turned on. Mm. Space and time began. Mm. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. So I'm following you. There's so many different ways I could take it, honestly. But and that's one thing I think a lot of people come to eventually once they start to raise their level of consciousness and awareness is, damn, like one thing that hit me was like, once I realized, man, I'm creating everything around me at all times. Like, is this person in fucking San Diego was the same energy that I was dealing with in Indianapolis, just with a different name? And I'm like, it's just energy, you know? And so, my question is when LeBron, let's say LeBron James is thinking he's LeBron James, and that's his ego. And most people get trapped into that attachment of thinking this is real,
right?
You know? And so what escapes people out of that and unplugs them from thinking They because 95% of people think this shit's real. They think whatever they think. You know what I'm saying? That's my first question. And then my opinion is heaven is a state of frequency, a state of vibration.
Yeah.
That can be here.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, that's my two.
So people don't realize, if you read every sacred book, it was always written esoterically, meaning it was pertaining to the inside part of you, the inner part of you, but it was speaking in parables.
Yeah.
So what you said, oh, heaven is a state of consciousness.
Yeah.
The kingdom of heaven is within you. It was a state of mind. It was a state of being. It was a state of consciousness. It was not a place that you had to get to. It was a state of presence. This is why when they ask, well, who's the greatest in heaven then? The children. Because the children haven't developed an ego yet that kept them from being present. Mm. So the ego is what, think like this, the ego is what lives in this simulation. Consciousness is what controls using the mind. Mm. The controller, when you play with LeBron, you got LeBron, and then you got the controller, and then you got you sitting on the couch. The controller was the medium, it was the vessel for you to be able to control LeBron. But here's what's really cool about us being human beings, is we have the ability through the mind to control the simulation. Yeah. You can control the simulation through your thoughts.
Yeah. I mean, it's like we touching a heavy, complex, esoteric topic and trying to like do it in a fucking podcast. But, and this could be, you know what I mean? This is deep.
Let those who have ears hear.
Yeah. Cause I'm under the impression, man, from my studies, my belief system, that as above, so below, as within, so without, as the universe, so the soul. So our bodies that you say are not here have mechanisms and components inside of it that once they get turned on, you have access to different dimensions and different levels of consciousness. And so I'm under the impression, being obviously the health guy and fitness guy, I'm realizing that the healthier this thing that you say is that not existing is, the more conscious I am on this plane of existence. So this thing you say is not existing is important.
It's your tool.
Yeah, so that's, I just want to clarify.
Yeah,
like,
no.
You saying it don't exist, but it's so important to, semen retention is important.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? Like you saying meditation, taking care of your temple is important. Like, you saying it don't exist, when I'm like, damn, this motherfucker is like, when you turn, once you start to realize, man, your vertebrae and how your chakras work, how energy works, how your body is so connected to your highest self. Like you realize, man, this is just an expression of something higher. So talk to me about that.
So it exists, but it's not the base reality is what I'm saying. Meaning this isn't it. That's what I'm saying. We know we have a body and it's a tool and we need it for this physical 3D incarnation.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is there's something more than that was infinite. This is finite. This is limited by the five senses. Once this is done, we're done.
Yeah.
But that which controls this is what I'm saying is outside of it. So while we're here in the simulation, while we're here in this 3D plane,
yeah,
this has to be in tip-top shape.
Yeah.
Because it was the vessel that connected the as above,
okay,
so below.
Okay, that's what I wanted to touch on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a huge vessel. I believe it's a huge vessel. And a lot of people, that's why I feel like this 3D keeps us in a toxic environment,
yeah,
a gossip, a distracted environment to keep you from connecting to that part that you speak of, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so the key was, because the ego is what lives in the simulation, right? The key was to realize that this body was just merely a tool. Mm. It's like when you use a hammer, you don't go back home and sleep with the hammer and eat with the hammer, you know it was just a tool for what you were building. Mm. This is what the body is. So the ego, though, wants you to make you think that this is you. This isn't you. So now when you start, here's what I do, I treat my body like a pet. I treat my body like how you have a dog or a cat. You make sure it gets the water that it needs.
Yeah.
You make sure you talk good to it. Mm. You make sure you feed it the right food. Mm. You make sure it gets adequate rest. Mm. You see what I'm saying? You make sure it has a nice shelter over it.
Yeah.
So I treat my human like a pet.
Mm. I haven't heard that one.
So now that creates separation. So now I'm not the ego. I'm not the ego. I'm observing the ego. So therefore I can't be it. The ego wanted you to make you think that you were it.
Yeah. So you treat it like a pet. That's deep. That's deep. And so talk to you, like, let's say, okay, back to kind of like breaking it down a little bit, man. So you're saying we live in a simulation.
Yeah.
We playing a game in the simulation. It's a game. You call this like you said, you reference Mario.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so let's say, and you reference LeBron James. So in this simulation, in this game that you call, in this whatever we call a simulation, what's Mario's, what LeBron James' responsibility? And what is it, just to enjoy the simulation, just to experience the simulation, just to reach the highest vibration possible in the simulation?
Yeah.
Or what do you feel like the purpose of the simulation is?
My thought is, my perspective is three things. Learn. Use every situation in life to learn. So the first thing I ask myself, good or bad, is what is this teaching me? And then whatever lessons learned, I grow from that. So I learn, I grow. And then lastly, the most important thing is love. Learning to love myself, because I cannot love anyone else until I learn how to love me. As I am on the inside, everything will be on the out. So learn, grow, and love, I believe, is why we're here. We're here to learn from every situation. This is why we get Notre Dame University, Oklahoma University. We hear the word universe.
Yeah.
It's a school. We're here to learn
and
grow, so you can see what you actually are, and you'll see that you weren't Super Mario. You weren't LeBron. You were the thing that was controlling it, which is pure love and light.
Yeah.
Learn, grow, love.
You say it's pure love and light, and I love that. You say learn, grow, learn, love.
Yeah.
So in that, back to the simulation, who or what is controlling the simulation right now?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
You want?
I'm just saying, like, because obviously, if 95 to 99% of people don't even know they in a fucking simulation, and you call this a simulation, and they just walk around here eating shit, fucking whatever they doing with their avatar that they think is them.
Yeah.
Then somebody is pulling the strings, because I know if I knew I was in a simulation and I knew everybody didn't know, I'll be pulling the damn strings.
Like,
you know what I'm saying?
You see what I'm saying?
So who's in control and who's running the simulation right now?
Think of it like this. When you play Super Mario, you got the controller in your hand. You're controlling Mario. Because you're controlling Mario, you're not in the game. You exist outside the game.
Yeah.
So that which is controlling you has to exist outside of space and time. That which controls you has to exist outside of the game, outside of this physical universe. See what I'm saying? So this is where people can't understand when they say, like, oh, well, the Big Bang. No, the Big Bang was just the beginning of space and time. That's what has created it. Consciousness has always existed. It always will.
Yeah.
So this is where a lot of people can't grasp the whole concept behind the simulation. That which is controlling is your spirit, is consciousness. That's all there ever was. That's all there is. That's what literally has created everything. You create your own individual world from your individual consciousness. Universal consciousness is what creates this whole universe. You are just a fractalized part of that. That's it. So you're the crumb that broke off the cookie that can create its own individual life. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So this is where, like, I have to remind myself that no matter what goes on in here, this is just a game. It's just a game.
What I'm saying is, how if I live by premise, if you're not creating, you're being created. And consciousness creates reality.
Correct.
We agree there?
Yeah.
Consciousness is what is the fabric of this third dimension.
Right.
And so if you're not intentionally creating, are you plugged? I believe that you plugged into a collective consciousness of the fear program of a 3D.
Absolutely.
And so who or what's responsible for that collective program of the 3D? Are the people still responsible for it, or are there other forces responsible for that collective? Because if you say it's all light, love, and all this, you know what I mean, rainbows and shit,
right,
like, that ain't what I see when I walk outside.
See, but
and so that's not what I see when I walk outside, and that's not what I see people experiencing. And so if everybody is from the crumb of love, it's like, man, it don't add up.
This is what we And I'd have to draw it out so you could see it. I have to draw it out. But we think love is, oh, I love, that's not what love is. Love is the binding.
Let me say this.
Yeah.
I'm not saying love like that. What I'm saying love is like you said, self-love.
Right.
Like, it's systems in place that aren't built. The foundation of the systems in place aren't built on love.
Absolutely. But here, I see what you're saying.
Yeah,
So when you walk outside and you see, like, man, all this stuff going on, like, this can't be.
Just the ideas and the thoughts and the processes, it's a different consciousness than where I'm from.
But yeah, it's all still part of the one. It's all still the same. It's all the same coin. It's just the other side of the coin. If we have heads and we have tails, we look at it and say, tails, man, what is tail? No, tails is part of it's part of it.
Yeah.
So this is where people, because we have an egoic, linear, logical thinking mind, we look at it and say, man, this don't look like it. That's judgment. If we were to step outside, this is what all of these sacred teachers were doing. If we go to extraterrestrials, they don't have an ego. They don't have, so we look at it and say, oh, that's, man, this is terrible. That's a judgment. That's a lower way of thinking. Everything just is. It just is. It's not good and it's not bad because it's all part of the whole fabric. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The dark,
it's part of the game.
The
it's
dark and the light work together.
Yeah. It's part of the game. It's just part of the game. And I feel you saying it, and hopefully I'm not trying to come from an ego perspective. I'm just coming from it. I'm coming from it from a perspective of I'm an observer.
Sure.
I'm observing, like, everything that I've seen growing up and witnessing.
Right.
I'm like, these people ain't controlling themselves.
They're not.
Something else is controlling them.
Something else, yeah.
And like, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I'm like, damn, like, this ain't, and it don't seem like, and you say I'm judging it, but I'm saying it don't seem like it's some coming from a love frequency. Because I feel like frequencies exist, and I feel like there are, and you saying it's all one, but I feel like there's something that's, especially melanated people, I feel like have been under some type of energy, like, I don't know, cultivation, like siphoning of their power. And that's just my opinion though, but go ahead.
So, if I hear
not to be in an argument and state it all. I'm just kind of talking from my perspective.
Because here's how I view it. I view it like this. If I'm playing in a basketball game, and let's just say I'm come down and I turn the ball over.
Yeah.
Dude goes in, go on the other end, gets a layup, we end up losing. That one turnover was just a part of the whole game. It didn't sum up the whole game. You see what I'm saying? It wasn't the whole game. That was just one, you know what I'm saying? But this is what happens, though, when we look at situations in life. We're like, oh, man, this is weird.
When you isolate things out.
When you isolate things out.
And that's what I wanted you to get to.
We look like this instead of seeing, like, nah, this is actually a part of the whole. This is what 5D consciousness does.
Yeah.
I don't look at the turnover.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
So we're doing it to ourselves.
That's what I'm trying
okay,
to say.
Okay, we do, okay.
That's what I'm saying.
We're doing it to ourselves.
We're doing it to ourselves.
To wake ourselves up to our power.
That's it. Can't nobody take your power from you.
And you're not a victim.
Son, that's what I'm saying. See?
I wanted to get there.
That's
key.
That's it.
That's key.
So now you come from a place of.
You realize shit like, damn. And I needed an adversary to build my muscles, to build these unseen powers, to ultimately take over the game.
Son, that turnover was what made you get back in the gym to get your handles right, so that would never happen again.
Yeah.
But when you're in the thick of it, it's like, oh my gosh, man.
And the people that get it the worst is the people that got to build the most unseen muscles to dominate their reality, to take this to a higher level of.
Son.
Yeah.
That's why if you're going through something tough, rejoice in tribulation.
Yeah.
See, spirit speaking, man, I got goosebumps right now, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's real tough. We good?